What is up, guys? So Sports back in with another video. And in today's video, I guess you could say this is a part two to my sleeper prospects video that I did 2 days ago. So this is five more sleeper prospects and the 2019 NBA draft. And let's get into it. Starting off, my first guy I want to talk about is Luka Samanić out of Croatia. Now, this is a guy who has a great shooting stroke with great ball handling skills for someone of his size. He has good IQ. I think he can come in and fill his role nicely. And those European players always come in and always do work off the bat. So I feel like he can just continue that trend. Now, his problem is his defense lacks a lot. But again, I mean, as a forward, that's something that you can hopefully, you know, fix. If it was more of a wing type thing, maybe I'd be scared. But with the forwards, how the forwards play now, and especially a power forward, because he's 6'9", 6'10". So even if he isn't the best defender when he comes in, you can move him out to center. Centers nowadays, you have to be able to shoot. You know, shooting is essential in the NBA, and as long as you can do that, you're fine with everything else. So that's why I think he'll be a sleeper, because people will probably look at his defense and say, oh, you know, maybe he won't have the best success. But I mean, he has a great shot, and like I said multiple times already, that is all you need if you're a big man to succeed, a shot. So yeah, that's my first one. Moving on, I want to talk about Isaiah Roby. Now, Isaiah Roby is a weird one out of Nebraska. He has great size and great like physical traits and stuff. He's like 6'8", 6'9", 214. He has a great standing reach, great vert. But I don't know. I don't think he can put it all. He needs to put it all together. That's his problem. He hasn't found a way to put it all together yet. And offensively too, he isn't really that skilled. He can't. His ball handling is pretty good for someone of his size. But then again, he can't really create his own shot. He can't really dribble his way to the rim. He's a decent playmaker for someone of his size, but isn't anything like eye-opening or whatever. So I think that's it. He's just really raw. And if he can, you know, develop those traits, you know, increase his ball handling, get better at things like that, he'd be great. And also, a thing is, like I said with Luka Samanić, if he was a great shooter, I think he'd probably be over Luka in my opinion, but he needs to develop a shot. You know, his shot is very rugged. And if he can do that, again, he'll be great. And moving on, though, next guy I want to talk about is Cameron Johnson. Now, I don't think Cameron Johnson is, so to say, a sleeper, but I believe reasons why a team will pass on him is definitely because of his age. I mean, he's already 23 years old, and he's been in college for a while. I think he's been in college since 2014-ish. He redshirted, I believe, with Pitt, and then transferred to UNC. But I mean, he's a veteran college player, as many people like to say, guys who are senior pluses, you know, if you're a senior. But with him, a guy, great size, and he's an incredible, incredible, incredible shooter. I believe he shot around 46% from three at UNC. That is amazing. That is amazing. But then again, I see him just being a team that needs, you know, shooters, that needs vets, a playoff team that are strapped with cap, that just need a guy to come in and fill your role and do your role perfectly. Some teams like the Warriors and the Sixers and potentially the Thunder too. Guys, teams that have no cap to use, that need to fill out their roster and improve and get shooters. All those teams need shooters. I mean, talk about the Thunder. They have great versatility, great athleticism, but they're lacking shooting. The Sixers, with how their trades are going, how they could potentially lose on Tobias Harris and Jimmy Butler, they're going to need some more guys that can come in and hold their own. And I think Cameron Johnson can hold his own. Again, an amazing shooter, and he's 6'9". So if you want to play him at the 3, at the 4, you can also do that. Hopefully he can get his physicals up. I believe he's only like 210. If he can gain around like 20 more pounds, say 15 to 20, you know, that just help him if they do plan on moving him out to the 4 and playing him alongside Joel Embiid. But I mean, again, I think he'll be a great player. Hopefully he doesn't come in and have maybe like a Taurean Prince type start to his career, where he needs a couple years to probably get accustomed to it. Because I mean, by then he would probably be like 26-ish going into his first contract, or 27-ish going into his first extension, so to say. And you don't really want that, because you won't get the best contract out of, you know, you won't get the best contract, because I mean, you're already 27 getting your first extension. I mean, teams are going to look at you like you're already super old. you know, and you haven't really done anything, I hope he can come in and be an immediate impact. And that's what I do think he will be, you know. That's what I think he will be. Moving on to my next player, though, Ty Jerome from Virginia. Now, this guy is amazing. He has an amazing IQ. He's great spot-up shooter. He's a great shooter in general. He shot just a hair under 40%. I believe he shot 39.9% from Virginia this past season. Talk about a guy who's a champion, you know, so he knows what it takes to win. And he's unselfish. You know, he's a team player, a team guy. He's a hustler. Now, his problem is he's unathletic, you know. But, I mean, then again, in this day and age in NBA, you don't need to be athletic at all. This is not, you know, the 80s or the 90s-ish. You just need to have an amazing shot, and he has an amazing shot. So, I think he'll be able to use that great shot and have success in the NBA. And that's definitely, that's what I want to see out of all these guys, just success, you know. Maybe if it isn't with the team that drafted you, hopefully whatever team that gives you a chance can, you know, you can have a great success. And moving on to our final player now, Daniel Gafford out of Arkansas. Now, I just want to talk about the negatives of him really quickly before I talk about the positives, because he does have a lot of negatives. Excuse me. I don't know. He's just not a modern day center. He doesn't have a great shot at all. His shot is very poor. That's a big problem. And he just has a bad touch on shot, and you can see it when he drives to the rim. He doesn't have that great touch off the ball, putting into the hoop, and that's why he just looks kind of lazy out there. Lazy shot, can't really shoot. So he's gonna definitely need some time to grow. 100%. I can see him being a multi-year D League player. Excuse me, not the G. Or is it the G League? I think it is the G League now. Multi-year G League guy. But then again, I mean, he's a low usage type of guy who can give you some high efficiency. I mean, talk about it. I compare him kind of to like a Willie Cauley-Stein. Willie Cauley-Stein is a guy who averaged, what, 13 and 8-ish, I believe. Not a modern-day center who doesn't have a touch at all, possibly, with the ball. But I think Daniel Gafford probably has a better IQ, maybe. Both those guys don't need the ball to be effective. Then again, Willie Cauley-Stein is effective in his own way. So, there's that. But I mean, yeah, he's just like a low usage type of guy. Maybe he can be there for a playoff team again, like I said, with the Cameron Johnson. But I mean, Daniel Gafford is what, 20, I think. So I think he'll definitely be one of those G League type of guys, multi-year G League type of guys. Maybe we can see a Pascal Siakam type of girl from, hopefully. But again, he doesn't have a shot. If he can develop a shot, I think he'll be great in this league. But I mean, yeah, that's going to do it for this video, though, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy. This was five more draft prospects in the 2019, sweeper draft prospects, excuse me, in the 2019 NBA draft. But it's been So Sports, and I'm out. Peace.